Hello, this is the opening. Odd, isn't it? Hello, my name's John and this is my show.
We're pushing up daisies, we're falling apart. Their armies are marching, we're playing the cards. The scissors are coming to cut out your heart. The scissors are pointing before you can start.
Dinky dink. Nothing like a nice cup of tea. What time's the war start again? I'm John, right? For 20-odd years now, I've run something called a career. But it's always been based on I don't lie to people. I'm just telling you like it is. No lies, no fake, no fraud. But when I run into fake and fraud, believe me, I ain't gonna withdraw politely. This is Johnny Rotten. Enjoy or die. Hello, is this the entrance? La Rosie Show?
It is. I'm Rebecca from the Roseanne Show.
All right, I'm John.
Nice to meet you.
Smile, you're on candid camera.
Hello, how are you?
Oh, make me look gorgeous. And I like that pale as death look anyway, because I ain't got a choice about it.
You look pretty good, I'm just
going to... Oh, I just say that to all the boys.
Where are you going?
The Roseanne Bar
Show. Oh, have fun. How are you doing?
Hello, office people. Thought I'd say hello. Look, everything half-eaten. I see Roseanne's been here. Is that supposed to be her?
That is her.
Vile hands. I'm not going to be rowing with her. Hello, green room. I've seen your face about, and you don't do bad stuff, so
thank
good
you,
for
sir.
You.
Thank you, cheers. Thank
all right,
you.
Mush. Enjoy. I'm not to be rude to Roseanne. I mean, isn't that damn hilarious? Just met the rudest woman on earth.
I didn't want you saying anything derogatory about her within reason.
You will not censor me. If I have something derogatory to say, it's because she'll deserve it. If she's polite, she'll deserve that too.
No. I want to talk to you guys.
I always walk in
at the... Guys. No way.
Turn the camera off. Turn the camera off.
Why?
And can you guys step outside? I'm the executive producer of the show.
Mm-hmm.
Hi, I'm Judy.
Hello, I'm John.
You guys,
out, guys.
Please.
Not kidding.
Yeah, come here.
Hey, don't talk to me like I'm a lap dog. Come here. Who the hell do you think? No, you come here. Well, it appears they won't let us film rehearsals and they're pulling attitudes with us. Hello, hello, somebody talk to me.
Oh, hold on a second.
Barbara?
Hold on.
I have this agreement in front of me saying I can film backstage. This is backstage. What would you like me to hold on to, another camera?
I think you should wait a second.
Wait for what? What am I waiting for? I was told when I came here that I would be allowed full access to film wherever I wanted and do whatever I wanted, basically backstage. But now you're telling me I have no access?
Exactly. You've broken the rules and you're
And what rules would those be, Mrs.? Because I have it clearly written here. You are contradicting your own agreement. We have a written agreement here. You faxed this to us.
Know,
we're doing exactly what you agreed to us to do.
No,
oh, we're no longer on the show. Look, I am now being removed from the Roseanne Barr Show.
I'm Russ.
security manager.
Hello.
If you get me on camera, at least you can tell me about me.
This is Rotten TV. Peace! I've been banned! The century.
Let's start the bidding here at $3,000. $3,200, $3,500, $3,800, $4,000, $4,200, $4,500, $4,800.
All of this is apparently worth loads of money. Well, not to me. I find it all irrelevant. Motley Crue's boots, Cher's pants, Grateful Dead underwear. Ugh, filth. A Sex Pistols t-shirt signed by a pretentious moi. And a Beatles ticket to Shea Stadium. All apparently worth loads of money. I cannot imagine why. I'm going to add to this, before I eliminate it, one Sid Vicious death note to Nancy Spungen. It reads, "We had a death pact. I have to keep my half of the bargain. Please bury me next to my baby." It's sad and stupid, and goodbye is about the only thing on it that made any sense from Sydney. This is apparently worth money, but Sydney will understand. It has to be eliminated.
3, 2, 1.
It's what these people have done that is relevant, not what they wore while doing it.
$19,000,
$45,000, $50,000. Talking about VJs, talking about VJs. What you're about to see is real people applying for a real job on Rotten TV. I did this to see what makes people want to be VJs. And what I found out was that music meant nothing at all to them.
I am here because I would like to have some fun being a VJ kind of guy.
A VJ is somebody that knows about music, knows what's hit.
Where basically the person introduces and hosts a show.
It's somebody who gets the music out there and lets people know how they relate to the artists.
In other words, someone who knows what they're doing rather than a psycho babbler.
No, that was just bull. I was just joking with you.
You sound like you've got the job. All right, my name's John. This is for Rotten TV, and we're looking for a VJ to yap and wax lyrical about music.
My name is Dwight, and I have to say, for first of all, I am the biggest fan of Britney Spears.
Next!
See, I can, like, what type of dance do you want? Like,
is that to any specific song?
Well, sing for me, sing, like...
It looks like you're imitating the Macarena or something.
Crappy.
No, I don't sing, I don't dance.
Well, you're rocking in a free world. I like the dress.
I like your suit.
I have never met a girl.
Next!
Hi, I'm ready, you see. 150,000 miles out, I'm ready. Hi, how are you? I'm a crazy grandma, 49 years old. What's the matter, darling? I'm not your type.
Hello, what a
get time. Down, bend over with those funny clothes of yours. I'm sorry, we can't use that in TV. I love your English accent.
Next! I cannot deal with it.
Oh, hey, you son of a gun. What the hell are you doing?
Please leave the building. You are insane, woman.
I like to be insane. Everybody's so normal.
Music-wise, I work in a strip club and I date a musician, so...
What is it that Mr. Rotten is looking for?
Which Woodstock festival was actually played at Woodstock?
Excuse me?
Which Beatle played bass?
I don't know.
Who played bass for the Beatles?
Oh, John Lennon.
Can you name any of the Backstreet Boys?
No, but they're sure cute.
Excuse moi?
I love my Rotten TV.
I love my Rotten TV.
Good, you're all sacked. Oh, there you go, the sad world of I want to be a VJ. It's not about who does anything anymore. but about who presents it. If you have any aspirations in life at all, it should always be what you want to do and not talking about what others are doing.
Hi, I'm Kurt Loder. Welcome to the
And now going home for another night of decadent debauchery. Look, after all these years as a rock star, no herpes.
Oh.
Hello, Rotten does his ear yet again.
Don't smell it, no, don't smell it.
Hello? Yes, this is Baby Doll. You want to do what to me? And then you want to come over and do what? And then you want me to do what? What time can you come over?
Hollywood's newest alleged high-priced madam pleaded not guilty to charges that could land her in jail for up to 6 years. Jodie Diane Baby Doll Gibson seemed more concerned about her image than the charges. She said she's not a madam, but a singer.
Hello, this is John here, and I'm about to interview a so-called alleged notorious Hollywood-type madam.
You guys all set?
The most amusing thing I found was them sending the questions in advance.
I can't wait to meet Johnny.
And all writ out in very big lettering so an idiot like me wouldn't make a mistake.
I'm pretty spontaneous. I'm not really that premeditated.
And this took planning on their part. I mean, look. Hello, baby doll. Welcome
Hi.
To the music industry.
Thank you.
More than welcome, and I'll tell you it's about time because, as far as I'm concerned, this industry needs a breath of fresh air, and young talent should be applauded. So tell us, when did you first start singing?
Well, I've been singing since I'm about 9. I originally started singing music completely contrary to pop.
But when did you first consider yourself a professional, say, as a pop singer?
When I got paid.
You have hit records in other parts of the world, the Far East.
Actually, Good Girls did very well internationally. I did never released it domestically until now.
Tell them you're big in Bangkok, that'll get you airplay.
I've got a pop rock track that was actually written for Cher before she decided to do disco. I've got straight ahead club dance stuff and your pop. I mean, it's kind of eclectic.
And this all comes out, of course, from the fact that you can play keyboard, so you're already
yes.
set in that department.
Somewhat. Yeah, I don't know that I could. Maybe.
Oh, that was pretty good. What's the name of your first CD?
Single, you're talking about? Good Girls Go to Heaven, Bad Girls Go Everywhere. Appropriately enough.
Yeah, we never said what label it's on. It's on TDK, apparently.
No.
So from one working man to a working girl, well done, Mrs.
Thank you. Thank you. It's the most fun I've had since my arrest on June 8th. I am heading that way.
Right. Well, I'll escort you to your limo.
Okay. Okay, well, we'll just... actually, the limo...
Yeah. Your so-called real rock and rollers, they run like I'm the plague. Baby Doll came forth.
May the road rise.
Whatever she does is absurd by any standards, but there's a genuine, childlike honesty about her that makes her shine so much better. than the Courtney Loves of this world. Look, if you disagree with anything I'm saying here, there is a website for you to interfere with and put your own personal point of view across to. And I will respond, and I want that, because that's the whole point. If we're going to ever clear up what is wrong with this industry, that's where we begin. You, the public, and me, as a member of the public. Image Limited. From day one, rock and roll was about honesty, apparently. Hello, here we go. Whole bunch of people I've invited here tonight that didn't turn up, and there's only one reason why. They will not talk directly to me, which means you. I wanted to talk to Ozzy Osbourne. You've done such great stuff over the years, starting with Black Sabbath. You know, you're a working class Englishman here. But he can't be bothered to turn up. The only thing I can say about you, Ozzy, is never have your ex-wife as a manager. Somebody kill me. Courtney love Kurt's money. With your wonderful excuse, I'm making a film. Kill me. You love the idea of being a rebel, but you haven't proved to me or anybody exactly what being a rebel is. What are you rebelling against? You're just a pile of confusion. Take everything I want you to. Yeah, cheap fake. Axl Rose. His mediocre excuse at the moment is that he's in studio recording. This is a man who also at the same time proclaims that he loves my singing style. You're a fraud. And I'm underwhelmed. Neil Young, where are you? Through your management, I heard you had the cheek to say you only talk to people you know. Well, then explain this song.
The king is gone, but he's not forgotten. This is the story of Johnny Rotten.
Rock and roll will never die, but you f***s will. There it is. And I slag myself off just as much as anyone else. Because I deserve it when I'm wrong. And so do you. And you, Mr. Public, and Mrs. Publico, you deserve it too. You do not need to be lied to any longer. May the road rise. Johnny loves you. Because he's one of you.
In real life, I think he'd probably be a pompous ass.
What you said, he was a pompous ass?
And he comes and he says what a lot of people want to say.
I don't see it working.
But I mean, why couldn't, Neil Young show up? Why he wrote a song about the guy, you know? Why can't he show up?
And I also wish, actually, that he had gotten to Roseanne because she herself is such a confrontational bitch.
Well, here I am, big time rock star, completely being ignored.
This man is willing to go where other people aren't willing to go.
I think it was nice to see this guy who's like this punk rocker, wild guy, and he's sort of talking about having integrity, you know? Mm-hmm. And I liked that.
As long as he keeps making fun of himself.
Yeah.
So it's not like he's up here and he's making fun of the little people.
Why
knowing how he is, would anyone come on and want to be downsided or broadsided by his comments and stuff and be brought onto that to be made fun of?
The biggest appeal it would have, actually, is the Sesame Street teenagers. I remember years ago when I first watched Sesame Street, I did not understand the way it jumped from here to here to here to here and nothing connected.
This show's been so close to being good.
Hey.